Thank you for wanting to find out a little bit more about how to become an organization problem slayer. So, if your organization is going through a merger or an acquisition, or it's been hit with a new government regulation, there's been a dip in performance of your organization, maybe you're moving to a new facility, or maybe you're growing so fast that you can't keep up with the demand, we want to share with you a framework that can help you solve those chronic problems within your organization once and for all.
Yes, those problems represent pain, whether it be an acute pain when the C-suite says something has to happen right away, or that dull, chronic, aching pain that comes from an organization that things just aren't working as well as they should. Organization problem slayers remove the pain that companies feel when they have to hire, train, or transition large amounts of information to their teams in a short amount of time under a tight budget.
So oftentimes, we hear things like, well, it feels like we solve the same problems over and over and over again. We hire people with a lot of potential, but they keep making the same mistakes. It takes too long for people to get really good at what they're doing. We need to start serving our customers much more rapidly. So let's talk about how we make those chronic issues go away for good.
So this is good, sound practice and probably things you've heard of or tried before. But here is where the organization problem slayer changes the game. In order to really eliminate the pain, there are three things that we believe have to happen. First, you have to create a clear and common language for the learning. And that doesn't mean translated learning through an external consultant, but instead capture the voice of the people who really do the work. Secondly, that we've got to make sure to transfer ownership of the learning to the people doing the work. That doesn't mean create responsibility or accountability. It's more than that. It means that they have to feel like they are contributors and they must actually know what the process is for creating the learning. And third, they need to be able to make the changes and to be able to adapt to sustain this process. That means that they have to feel clear and confident to be able to address the issues, to be able to recreate the process and solve those problems when they are just small before they get to chronic or acute.
And the magic here is that once that problem is solved and we have given you the tools, the techniques, and the knowledge to be able to solve that problem, you now have the ability to do that over and over and over again within your organization. So if you're interested in learning about how you can make this happen in your organization, contact us to find out how.